We are so excited to be back outside in the fresh air, and we're also so excited for our exclusive Broadway announcement from three of the biggest hit musicals on Broadway. So let's get to it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are delighted to announce Broadway is back. On Tuesday, September 14th, 2021, with Hamilton, The Lion King, and Wicked.
We are joined now by stars from three Broadway blockbusters, L. Stephen Taylor, who plays King Mufasa in The Lion King, Krystal Joy Brown, who plays Eliza in Hamilton, and Alexandra Billings, who plays Madame Morrible in Wicked. Thank all three of you. Thank you, all of you, for joining us this morning. And L. Stephen, I'm going to start with you. First of all, thank you for that voice that you used in that voiceover right there to give us this exciting message. And you performed in The Lion King for 15 years. That's over 5,000 performances. So when that curtain rises for the first time in September, what's that going to feel like?
Oh, man, it's kind of indescribable. I mean, that moment already in Circle of Life is just an iconic moment. Mm-hmm. And, you know, from Pride Rock, I have a different kind of special viewpoint. So I say that my favorite thing to do is to stand there on Pride Rock and watch all the grown men cry. But honestly, from Rafiki's opening call, you know, it's a really a call for the community to come together. And I feel like that's what this is symbolic of. Broadway coming back, it's really a community coming back and making New York really start to go.
Yeah, and it just feels right when the lights are lit up on Broadway and these shows are going in. Alexandra, it's 18 weeks till showtime.
I know, don't remind me.
So how are you preparing? How are you getting ready?
I'm hoping that I don't fall head over heels into the orchestra pit because, you know, we have a thing that goes like that. You know what I'm doing is I'm saying to myself, I'm so blessed, I'm so grateful, and I'm so honored to be a part of telling this story that for me, just as a mixed-race trans woman on Broadway, that I only hope that what we can do is open a portal for dialogue, for change, not just for Broadway, but for the people that come to see us. So I'm just sitting in my gratefulness and very happy.
Absolutely, we're all very happy. You know, the Broadway industry of Krystal is committed to providing healthy and safe, you know, environments and theaters for everyone based on the CDC guidelines, based on the New York City guidelines, but that's not the only thing they're doing.
Right. Well, we've taken a lot of steps, not only to make sure that the theater is going to be safe for all of our audience members, but to make sure that our cast and crew have been trained in anti-racism training, also making sure that we as a brand are pushing forward social justice. We all came to a reckoning after watching George Floyd's horrifying murder, and we realized that as a company, as a brand, we can come together and do some amazing work. So we created something called Pam for Progress, and we have been working to make sure that there are voting rights and that we are giving scholarships and all kinds of things to continue to show equity and inclusivity in our community. And we hope that this is the first step for Broadway to continue to do this type of work because we can make absolute change. And we are representing so many people, yeah, and they can see us. And so Broadway being accessible, Broadway being diverse and inclusive is an amazing thing for all of us. And once we're back, will be better than ever, and New York City can revive as well.
Yeah, no doubt. And L. Stephen, it's happening at more than just Hamilton. It's happening at The Lion King as well and other theaters.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this call for change and call for our theater spaces to be more inclusive and equitable has been going on for a long time. And now, finally, there's a lot of work going on behind the scenes. I know that at Disney Theatrical, we've been partnering with a lot of organizations in the community, like Broadway Advocacy Coalition, Black Theater United, and Black Theater Coalition, to make sure that we're actually supporting impactful systemic change. So then when we come back, like Krystal said, we come back, but not only returning, but returning stronger and better than we were before.
And Alexandra, the ecosystem for Broadway is huge. Almost 100,000 people depend on Broadway for work.
So, they told me that in the green room. I did not know that.
Directly or indirectly, almost 100,000 people. So what are you looking most forward to when it comes to going back to work?
You know, I'll tell you, when I was in the show, when I was in Wicked before this terrible thing happened, there were an enormous amount of trans youth that were getting a hold of me. And I mean 10, 11, 12-year-old children who were in the middle of a transition. And they would come to the show and stand and ask for autographs with their parents. And it was the first time they had ever seen another transgender person before in their lives. If you can imagine this, having no representation at all. So seeing yourself reflected in art for the very first time is extraordinary, both for myself and for them.
Well, I'll tell you this, there will not be a dry eye in the house, and tickets are on sale now.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.